Oh, snap. Fourth cup of coffee for the day. I'm so sorry I'm posting a second video today, but this is urgent. Here's the thing. Tomorrow, something crazy comes out that is basically going to tell us when the bottom of the market is, or was the bottom of the market Monday? I don't know, but tomorrow's gonna be a really big day. And I wanna forewarn you what to look for. There are three specific things that we wanna do going into tomorrow so that we're prepared for what happens tomorrow. Quick analogy, when I was in third grade, my teacher always said, Kevin, when you're reading, you have to learn how to read in between the lines. And so I would write things outside of the lines and look really closely, and things didn't work out for me. I was an immigrant from Germany. I didn't understand what was going on. Things just went over my head and below my knees. I was clueless. I felt like an idiot. Well, oftentimes I feel like an idiot when I'm looking at stocks too. Like, oh, red. Red is bad. Not good. Wonder what happened. Oh, green. Green, good. What happened? Oh. And that's exactly why this video is so urgent, because I want to show you some things that you want to be looking for that are going to happen tomorrow, but it's not going to be readily apparent. We're going to get a bunch of crazy headline news articles tomorrow about what's coming out tomorrow, but you want to look in between the lines, and I'm going to show you exactly how to do that right now. Thursday, March 26th at 8:30 a.m. Eastern time. So 5:30 a.m. my time, I'm setting my alarm clock for this one. Right before the stock market opens, like 30 minutes before, new jobless claims numbers are going to come out, which that might sound boring. I know initially you might be thinking, okay, all right, we're gonna see a spike in jobless claims. No, that's not all I'm gonna tell you. The three things are what matter. The basic black and white text is gonna say something like, this is how many jobless claims we've had in the last week, and this is how many we've had since the start of this madness and this crisis that we've been going through. That's the black and white stuff. I really wanna focus your attention on what those numbers are going to mean. See, the black and white part is already pretty dang apparent. It's gonna be ugly. It's gonna be bad. It's gonna be unprecedented and shocking. When the Associated Press is saying that entire cities are essentially shut down, and history gives us no guidance for something like this. In fact, when we look backwards, we see, wait, the highest number of jobless claims in one week in history was 700,000. What we're going to see tomorrow might 5 to 10x that number. California and Pennsylvania alone, just two states, have seen over 1.5 million jobless claims in just the last 2 weeks. I called my dentist yesterday. They had to completely shut down the dentist's office. Even my dentist himself is applying for unemployment. He is one of those 1 million people in California, or 500 plus thousand people in Pennsylvania applying for jobless claims. But what does this mean? What do we have to look for? We know it's bad. We know it's going to be ugly. That's the black and white. Now let's read between the lines. Number one, there's a lot of speculation right now over when is the bottom of the market going to be. And that makes sense because a lot of us are really interested in knowing where's the bottom of the market. Like, if we look back and somebody told us, hey, here's the exact date of the bottom of the market in the 2008 recession, wouldn't we invest? Well, of course we would. We'd be like, I'll buy some stocks at the bottom, drink some coffee, and go retire on a beach with some Mai Tais in Hawaii. Yeah, I would want to do that too. That sounds awesome. You just happen to generally luck into those dates. Well, the numbers we're getting tomorrow could actually help us try to figure out where the bottom is. See, what happens with the stock market and even the real estate market, just markets in general, is markets generally try to predict what is going to happen. What that means is a certain prediction as to how bad this whole disaster and crisis is already factored into stock market prices today, bond prices today, fund prices today. It's already priced in. The only thing that's going to change that expectation is a new set of data that allows us to adjust our expectation upwards or downwards. So in practice, what that means is when we get this black and white number tomorrow, I need you to Google right at 8:30 what the heck the Dow did and the S&P did at 8:31. Like, set your alarm clock for this. Look and see what the indices are doing. If we see a big plummet in the stock market tomorrow at 8:31, you better be telling yourself, oh my gosh, this is way worse than expected, and the entire market didn't even think this was going to get this bad. Now, I need to be especially careful. Build more of a war chest. If you're really like enthused, go buy some stocks because there's going to be a big shock factor to what happens tomorrow. If you're really enthused, go buy some below market value real estate. But realize this shock value is going to tell us, okay, how long do we expect this is actually going to last? Now, stock markets can overreact, so you have to be careful. It is possible we see a big negative overreaction tomorrow. But the big signal is what we want to pay attention to. How much of this outbreak is already priced into stock market pricing? Again, if we see a big plummet, might be a good time to shop, might also be a good time to bump up the extra cash you have and prepare that war chest because we might be in this longer than expected. Now, what if the numbers are way lower than expected? Well, that could be good, but also bad because maybe people are so discouraged because the lines are so long to even file for unemployment that they're not even filing. Or the stock market priced in way too much risk for this outbreak. The stock market basically was too negative about everything that's going on and the long-term damage this is going to cause. And we'll actually see a substantial V-shape recovery starting tomorrow. Now, obviously, I'm expecting a lot of volatility tomorrow and the next days as people sort of adjust to this new data coming in. Tomorrow's going to be a very, very volatile day. But to me, the way the day starts and the way the day ends is going to be a huge signal for how our stock market is pricing what the heck is going on. Number two, you've got to go to the links below and use that link for Webull and get into those courses. All right, sorry, I had to do that. Okay, let's go to the real number two. Number two, if you are a business owner or you are an employee, realize that tomorrow at 8:31, you're going to get a big signal as well. You're going to know if you're an employee and jobless claims are way higher than expected, more companies are going to get even more nervous about keeping you longer term, and you might be filing for unemployment sooner than you thought. Which is bad. Like, none of us want to file for unemployment. And because none of us want to go through the pain of filing for unemployment, going through the paperwork, going to the office, doing all the stress and crap, a lot of us actually don't. We just go, hopefully this is just like a 2-week lockdown and then we'll be able to go back to work after that. You know, maybe it's just gonna last a month or two. And a lot of companies are saying, hey, you know what? We could float our employees' payroll for a month, 2 months. But if the stock market tanks tomorrow, that's gonna be a huge signal to businesses that we might have to actually lay off more people because we thought we were gonna be able to pay you for the next 2 months until this is over. Now, at this rate, doesn't look like it's gonna be over. Which I know sounds crazy because none of us can really accurately predict when this whole thing is actually going to end. But the market's expectations create fear in businesses. When company stock go down, they start getting fearful, they hoard more cash, and unfortunately, they lay off more people. Now, if you happen to be a real billionaire, you just keep your employees employed because it's the right thing to do. But a lot of companies don't have that benefit. So, if you're employed, consider this. Tomorrow's gonna be an indicator to your boss, whether you like it or not. If you're self-employed, it's an indicator to you. And number three, you better start preparing yourself in two ways. Prepare yourself for a potential job transition, at least in the meantime, if you need extra income. That is, go push a broom for the hospital. Like, the hospitals are looking desperately for workers right now. Be somebody who can answer the phone. Like, pick up the phone and go to doctor's offices, to hospitals, go to FEMA, go to Red Cross. All of these people are looking to hire people right now. There are plenty of jobs out there right now. Obviously, you could work for Amazon, CVS, these companies are doing massive job hirings. But beyond considering alternative opportunities, also build your war chest. Tomorrow is the indicator as to how much of a war chest you need. If the market tanks, yeah, you might potentially see a nice buying opportunity, but this also might be a sign that the market's starting to expect this might take a lot longer or be a lot longer of a recovery than we initially thought. If the market skyrockets, I mean, I'm not a big fan of buying on green days, but that could be an indicator that the worst has already been baked into the market prices and we'll have volatility. We're still gonna see crazy ups and downs, but maybe this means we'll see ups and downs averaging up as we start seeing case loads slow down with this outbreak, which is already what we're seeing in the state of New York. Now, by no means do I want to come across as predicting the future, but what I want you to think about starting right now is, how is a really bad stock day tomorrow going to affect your tenants, your investments, your stocks, your job, and your prospects for future jobs, and how much of a war chest you have? But also think about how a really good stock day is going to affect all of those things. And at 8:31 tomorrow, get your answer. Obviously, I'll probably do an update video on this, but I just want to give you a heads up because I can't film and edit a video in 60 seconds. So, good luck, everyone. Thanks so much for watching. Follow me on Instagram, and until tomorrow.